All right, we begin with some breaking news that is coming in at this moment. This is regarding the BJP MP Kirti Azad. Now, the latest that we are getting is that he is not attending the BJP Parliamentary Party meeting, which has begun. The Prime Minister is expected to give a speech in the BJP Parliamentary Party meeting, which was supposed to begin at 9:30 a.m. These are leaders who are going in. This comes shortly after the news of BJP thinking of suspending Kirti Azad. Now, remember, in a Parliamentary Party meeting, all the parliamentarians of that particular party are supposed to be in attendance. That is why it is called a parliamentary party meeting. Let's go across to Brijesh Pandey at this moment. Brijesh, is it all but certain now that the daggers have been drawn?
Well, you know, of course, I mean, the obvious inference, Sanket, right now is this only. But I've spoken to Kirti Azad. He said that, you know, that he's not coming. But he didn't give any reason why he's not coming. His camp is telling us that, you know, that if you look at his discourse, if you look at his speeches, he's not naming Arun Jaitley per se, but he has been fighting corruption against DDCA and factionalism within the DDCA for a very, very long time, almost close to a decade. So they are saying that, you know, what has actually happened is that Aam Aadmi Party and Congress has jumped the bandwagon, and they are trying to use his fight against corruption in DDCA as to maintain or sustain or start an onslaught against Finance Minister Arun Jaitley. But going by the statement which are coming off late, Siddharth Nath Singh, party spokesperson, has said that, you know, now time is ripe to take action against Kirti Azad. The next 24 to 48 hours will be extremely interesting, Sanket.
That's right. The next 24 to 48 hours are going to be very, very interesting, as Brijesh Pandey mentions. Still no absolute clarity on the BJP's official position. Remember, the BJP is in a state of deep thought as far as Kirti Azad is concerned, because even before the Aam Aadmi Party, this DDCA issue was being raised by Kirti Azad. However, all of it has gotten a great degree of traction only now, when Kirti Azad chose to speak in Parliament about this particular matter. Let's go back to Brijesh Pandey at this moment. Brijesh, there is great amount of detail that is trickling in at this moment about the likelihood of what Kirti Azad will do from here on. Can you please clear the air as to what is fact at this moment? Something that people are openly speaking about at this moment, the various political sides. What is Kirti Azad's next plan of action going to be? Is he going to be part in this legal battle against Arun Jaitley on behalf of the Aam Aadmi Party? Is he going to stay in the BJP or not? A number of unanswered and open-ended questions.
Well, Sanket, I don't think he will leave BJP on his own. He says that, you know, he has been a member of BJP ever since, you know, the party was not in power. He's a third time MP from Darbhanga. And the fact of the matter is that he's saying that, you know, which we all have to acknowledge, Sanket, that he says, and this is the fact, that he has been fighting this battle against corruption in DDCA for 9 years. And he says that Aam Aadmi Party and Congress are trying to usurp the corruption war which he started and has been waging for the last 9 years. Now, the biggest problem before the BJP is that, you know, that he's not the lone case. You know, we also saw the case of Shatrughan Sinha. The BJP is slightly divided about the course of action to be taken against him. If they take any action against him, for the first, the obvious part would be that the party will issue a show cause notice to him and will give him a time frame for which to reply. And it is his reply for which the party will assess and will try to, you know, understand whether this calls for an anti-party meeting, whether this constitutes anti-party activities or not, and post then a decision will be taken. If the BJP decides to expel Sanket, I think it would be bad politics, because then literally it would be like, you know, handing over a position on a platter to the opposition party. Even if he doesn't join Aam Aadmi Party in Congress, you know, as a sole member of as an individual MP inside the parliament, he can make the situation very bad for the BJP, because remember he has been quoting.
He'll position himself as a martyr. He'll say, look, I was fighting for you know, internal justice, and I never got one.
He will position himself as a martyr, Sanket, and you know, in some sense, rightly so, because it is not that he just you know, day before yesterday stood up and started talking against DDCA corruption. He has been waging a lone battle for a very long time. So he is saying that he has not been indulging in any anti-party activities. He also says, his camp says, that he has not named Arun Jaitley per se, and all those WikiLeaks expose and the press conference, he said, was about exposing corruption within the DDCA over a stipulation limited period of time, which was also investigated by serious fraud SFIO and ROC. So he's saying that he has done nothing to embarrass his party. It's just the timing of certain things are such that, you know, that Aam Aadmi Party has also jumped the bandwagon and, you know, trained his gun on Finance Minister Arun Jaitley. Sanket?
There was a major goof-up this year in one of the most coveted beauty pageants, Miss Universe. The 2015 host for the ceremony, Steve Harvey, declared Miss Colombia the winner when in fact she was actually the first.